Hey guys, Steve from Unexplored Films here, and today we're going to try an aging morph effect as seen in films like Titanic and Saving Private Ryan. Now, I've been wanting to try this effect for a really long time. It is one of my favourite devices used in a film to link present-day sections with flashbacks. And as with all good effects, it's not just used for its own sake, it really serves the story and gives it some emotional punch. So this was a really fun effect to replicate, and we found that with a bit of planning, this is a surprisingly simple effect to pull off nowadays. And if you're interested in filmmaking and practical effects and visual effects, please consider subscribing and you'll get to see lots more. So this effect is normally done with two different actors of different ages who are playing the same character, and this is a really good way to try it, especially if you have two family members that look really similar. We were actually going to try this with a grandfather and a grandson we know. Unfortunately, we couldn't do this in the end because of the lockdown, so instead I ended up playing both parts and we used some prosthetics and makeup to age me for the old version. Now, these days there are lots of programs and apps that can actually age you artificially, but we wanted to try this as a mostly practical effect like they do in the movies, and the only reason we used makeup to age me was because we couldn't do it with two actors on the day. So looking at the Titanic example, I think they probably filmed both faces as similarly as they could get them, and then did some digital zooming and realigning to try and get them lined up perfectly on top of each other. The camera zooms in so far that you can't see the edges of either face, so the only thing that really needs to line up is the eye. We decided to base our effect on the shot from Saving Private Ryan, because not only is it a full head and shoulders shot of the character changing, but Steven Spielberg has got really clever and done it in the middle of a camera move. The camera moves in from left to right, the change happens over about 10 seconds, and now we're in a completely different location and the camera carries on moving. So they've obviously had a go at matching the lens and the angle and the distance of the camera from the two actors. But you'll notice that they've made life easier for themselves by shooting the moment where the change happens with both actors against an overcast sky, which basically just looks like a white background. This means they could probably do a lot of fading between the layers without having to worry about the background changing as well. So these clues were enough for us to try and have a go at this ourselves, and we decided to shoot this against a white backdrop in our studio. Now, the easiest way to do this would of course be to do it on a tripod with a locked off camera, but we wanted to copy what Steven Spielberg had done and put it in the middle of a moving shot. And so we set up our slider for the camera to move along, and the plan was the camera would move along the first half of the rail, then we would lock it off with some weights, then swap out the young character with the old character, swap the weights around, and then do the second half of the camera move with the other character. We put some tape marks on the floor in front of the camera so that the young character and the old character could both stand on the same position. Now, obviously this would be harder if there were two different actors of different heights, but because they were both me for our test, this didn't matter. So we got our lights on and did the first part of the take, which was fairly simple. I stood on the tape marks dressed as the young character, who, like Private Ryan, is meant to be a soldier. Now, I'm currently in my early 30s, but we tried to make me look a little bit younger by giving me a shave and just arranging my hair a little bit differently. And we added a little bit of dirt makeup to my face as well.
All right, let's do it.
So you start the move ready when you are, okay?
So our shot here was roughly keeping the character in the center of the frame and doing a nice slow slide along the first half of the slider, and once the camera had stopped moving, we got the operator to count 10 seconds, and I tried to stay very still and not blink.
That wasn't bad. That wasn't bad at all. Should we try it again?
So once we had a take we were happy with, normally this is where you would swap in your second actor or go to your new location and film your second actor, but as I was playing both of them, I now had to transform into the old character. And if you want to learn exactly how we did that, we've got another video where you can see the makeup and prosthetic process that we tested for this effect. We actually shot this effect over 2 days. We filmed the young character on the first day, and then I spent most of the second day transforming into the old character. And then we shot the old character on day 2.
Lockdown's been really hard on me.
Now, this was the first time we had ever tried something like this with makeup and prosthetics, and although we didn't think it looked 100% realistic, we thought it was at least good enough to demonstrate this effect of swapping out one actor for another. So now we were able to move our weights that were locking the camera in place and do the second half of the same move. This time the operator began by counting to 10, and I stood very still, and then we did the slow camera move off to the right. For both characters, I stood on exactly the same spot and looked at exactly the same mark, so this was a pretty good way of getting the shots to match. Once again, we watched the best take back and were pretty confident that we could line this up with the previous one. And so now we could begin editing. So we created this shot in After Effects, and the first thing we did was to load up the two original takes, and we lined up the young take on top of the old take at the point where we were doing the 10 seconds of no movement. With the young take opacity turned down to 50%, now we could see both takes at the same time. So they were pretty similar, but not in exactly the same place. So now we could add some manual position keyframes to the young take and start shuffling it around to line up the face over the old take. Specifically, we were going for the eyes here, because I think that most people would normally be looking at the eyes in the face, and if the eyes line up, then you probably won't notice if other things don't. So pretty soon we had a bunch of keyframes to help line up the young take exactly over the old take. Now comes the main part of the editing, and that is to add the mesh warp effect to both layers. And we're going to use this to subtly distort one figure to turn it into the other one. And this was the same process we used in our Doctor Who regeneration tutorial. If you increase the rows and the columns to their maximum, you'll get the most detailed grid, which is what we want. And we can add a keyframe under distortion mesh at the beginning and the end of the section where we want the change to happen. Now we want the young clip to change into something that looks like the old clip over time. So if we leave the first keyframe as it is, we can go to the end one and begin to move things around. So now we can distort the young face to line up with the old one by pushing and pulling these corners of the squares around. So some of the things we were paying attention to here were lining up the top of the hair, making the skin sag a little bit under the eyes, lining up the mouth and nose slightly, moving the edges of the army coat to match the old man's jacket, and then trying to line up the shirt collar with the other shirt collar underneath. So now we have the young shot changing to look like the older shot. So now we can do the same process with the old clip, but in reverse. Set two keyframes, one at the beginning and one at the end, and this time we're going to leave the ending one alone, and now we can distort the beginning of the old image to look like the young one. So once again, we could shuffle everything around to try and make it match, and because we had lined up the eyes already, that was the one thing that doesn't need to move. So once you've changed everything on both layers, you can now keyframe the opacity on the young clip to start at 100% and end up at 0. This will slowly reveal the older clip underneath. And that is basically how we did our morph effect. Now we could improve the shot slightly more by adding a new null object and attaching all the layers to it, and we could then change the position and the scale of this to create a more interesting camera movement. Now, unlike Steven Spielberg, we didn't shoot this in two physical locations. We've obviously cheated using our stage. So to make the time periods look different, we could drop in some digital scenery on each side and keyframe it to match the movement of the walls of the studio. So we dropped in some damaged buildings for the wartime part of the scene and dropped in some footage from a war memorial, which we had shot for a previous documentary project for the second half of the scene with the old man. And this was the great thing about filming this against a white background. We could just use a simple mask to get rid of the edges of the studio, and that just left our figure in the middle of the frame to arrange these other elements around. Finally, we did some color correction to the whole image using an adjustment layer, and we found that changing the color grade can also suggest time passing or moving into a different time period. And if you look at films where scenes take place in different times, they often use different color grades to make this more obvious. So then we were done, and we could look back at the finished effect. So that was our version of the Hollywood aging morph effect, which we really enjoyed making. And why not drop a comment below about what some of your favorite effects from movies are, and we might try one of those next. So guys, I hope you enjoyed that. Please give it a like and hit that subscribe button if you enjoyed this. I've been Steve from Unexplored Films, and I'll see you next time.